Green lights it go. Good start from Toe Hill. Great from Steve Hill on the inside. Not so good away from Julian Godfrey. They squeeze each other down towards the first corner. Godfrey has to back out momentarily. Toe Hill's got the overspeed. Smoke billowing from the back briefly of his Ford Fiesta, but he leads the way into the first corner from Steve Hill and then from Julian Godfrey. So onto the gravel these drivers go for the first time. And it was a great start then from Derek Toe Hill from the outside of that front row of the grid. Now the crucial question is going to be with regards to Julian Godfrey, who's taken over Mark Donnelly's Citroën DS3. Is he going to have the speed to try and challenge these front runners? He goes Joker at the end of the first lap. Does Julian Godfrey decides to get himself out of the traffic as Toe Hill and Hill continue on the normal lap. Over the line they come. Already at the start of the second lap we are. These supercars are so fast around here. Even from a standing start, the time from a launch to the end of the first lap is only just under 44 seconds there and thereabouts. And this is great for Derek Toe Hill. He, of course, had a race where he ended up in the barriers in round five on Saturday here at round four, at Knockhill yesterday. And as such, he had a very difficult day at the office for the final, only finishing in fourth position, but seems to be just keeping his nose clean and his powder dry for the time being, and just keeping it nice and consistent out there on track. Good to see Steve Hill also facing the right way. He had a difficult final for Saturday as well and finished down in fifth position after leading actually earlier on in the race. Had a bit of a spin coming in towards T2. This is down at Duffers Dip. This is turn two into this right-hander, and that's where Hill lost it. And as such, hemorrhaged a load of time. And that was sadly putting him out of contention for the rest of the race, which he looked set to win at one point. And it was miraculously Robert Vittles who was able to turn his fortunes around after failing to get away from the lights at all. Just drove out of his skin, kept his nose clean, just drove very calmly and very comfortably and was out on track to take that win. Toe Hill then goes Joker at the end of lap two, the end of lap three, I should say, rather. We are now as he comes through into that chicane. So continuing on is Steve Hill. He's going to have his moment of glory in the sunshine, but of course he'll have to make that Joker at the end of this lap, which should, in theory, release Derek Toe Hill into the race lead. You can see there Julian Godfrey. I think one of the bonnet catches has actually come up on his Citroën DS3. Looked like it was flapping away in the air down in towards that first corner. But there is Steve Hill on the gravel section then. So he's got a 6 second advantage over Derek Toe Hill before he jokers at the end then of this lap. I don't think that's going to be enough for Hill to hold on to that lead by the time the checkered flag comes out. But going joker now then is Steve Hill. Let's see what's going to happen as he re-emerges. The brakes glowing red on that Mitsubishi Evo 10. He's slightly wide through the hairpin. Toe Hill is already coming through into that hairpin. It's going to be mightily close between them. But Toe Hill and Godfrey get themselves ahead. Over the line they come. Hill finishes third on the road. And you can see there was a bonnet catch that definitely did come loose from Julian Godfrey's car. But first blood then in round five of the supercars to Derek Toe Hill here in Scotland.